Back in March, the Aston Martin DB11 was revealed to the world's media and the public at the Geneva International Motor Show. It was revealed to great acclaim. The Daily Telegraph branded it the best car in show, and you may remember we brought you a short video with a short introduction to the DB11 from the stand itself. Now the car is here, physically with us at HWM, and we're really excited to present it to you not only again in video format, in a little bit more detail than we did before, and in a series of short videos focusing on different elements. Now this video, we're going to be looking at exterior design in particular, and we're going to go through some of the details that make it such a special car, that make it potentially not only the most desirable and gorgeous Aston Martin ever produced, but potentially the most beautiful car ever produced in the world. Starting at the front of the car, there's loads to talk about. Firstly, we have the largest production grille on any Aston Martin that's gone before, and it's, like all Aston Martins previous, made out of proper materials, so in this case aluminium, and that's then mated to this huge clamshell bonnet. So the clamshell bonnet is all aluminium. And actually the buyers had to go out and source the largest piece of aluminium they could. Now when we say clamshell, basically it wraps round into the front wings, and we'll show you that in a second. And the reason that we do this is so that there are no ugly shut lines within the bonnet. It is literally just one piece. Now it wasn't just a buying challenge to go out and source the largest piece of aluminium that they could, but also it's a challenge to engineer, and they had to find the largest press that they could to make it in this gorgeous shape. Now, as a result of having a clamshell bonnet, the only cutouts that you have are for the air intakes, obviously, and for the headlamps, which are mounted within the car, and then when the bonnet comes up, it wraps around. And that's an engineering challenge in itself, to get shut lines that are super tight and really well engineered and finished. Also, the nose of the car is quite shark-like, so the trailing edge of the bonnet here starts off at a sort of further outwards point than at the bottom, and it sharks inwards like so. Combined with this front splitter at the bottom, it creates a really aggressive look, actually, but without the car being overly aggressive and sort of snarling. It's a restrained aggression. Also, the badging, which is typically hand enameled in the jewellery quarter in Birmingham, like all badges have gone before, but these are the largest badges that we've had on any production Aston previous. And then we also have the nostrils within the bonnet of the car, features that we've seen on DB9 and we've seen on DBS, but the added design feature in this case are these blades that can be finished in either a brushed silver finish, like hit this, or in a gloss black. And then depending how you inspect the rest of the car, you would just have it match. So in this case, those blades match the grille that we saw at the front, and also the traditional Aston Martin side strake. So from Geneva, we paid particular attention to the side strake. In fact, I flustered my words a little bit when I presented it the first time. But the side strake is a very traditional Aston Martin feature. It's been on DB5, it's gone all the way through. But this is the first time we've made it work for us from an engineering point of view as well. And when we talk about the technical excellence of the car, we'll describe how this works as an aero aid, as well as a really gorgeous design feature. With regards to the side strake and how that works into the front wheel arch, it's quite an aggressive and rather savage cut where it goes into the front wings. And it's typically not something that's Aston Martin beautiful. but it's a really interesting design feature that sort of means this is a very contemporary Aston for the second century. We also have other aero, so you'll see where this cutout comes here. You can feel within there, and basically that channels air along the car. And also, there's a skirt that not only continues from the front splitter, but along the side of the car and into the rear diffuser. And these launch edition cars, that's finished in gloss black. The gloss black's really nice because it also links to the mirror arms, also the bottom of the swage line, and we'll go into details of like the roof scrape imminently. Now, if you follow me along the car a second, you have this very dominant line that runs all the way along the wing of the car. And this is actually really reminiscent of the 177, which had the same powerful line running the whole circumference of the car. It runs into the rear wing, and the rear wing, in terms of how swollen they are, one exudes the fact that it is a rear-wheel drive vehicle, but also gives underlying hints of the car's raw, purposeful power and brutality. It's quite similar to the old Vanquish in that respect. It's got that very muscular bruiser in a suit kind of finish, so very tailored, but you know, intrinsically a muscle car. The Aston Martin typical door handles remain. They will house probably some sort of keyless entry tech, but the doors, again, swan upwards in the fashion that we've come to expect, so that's 25 degrees upwards. And the great thing about that from a practical point of view is that they don't launch necessarily on high curbs, and they make entry and egress into the car far easier. It's also quite exotic having it like that. Looking at the wheels, so these are the wheels that were available on launch. Now they're known as a 10-spoke directional alloy wheel, and they're available in three different finishes. This particular finish is known as shadow chrome, so essentially you paint the wheel black underneath and then an almost chrome finish on top. And that, combined with this magnetic silver paint and all the black detailing, gives it quite a stealthy and restrained look. However, if you want something a bit more jewel-like, you can have this with a diamond turn face, where essentially the front of the wheel is milled, and then the back of the wheel is painted a different colour, and that would be either black or silver. The silver will look typically very elegant, the black looks very dynamic and racy, and the black wheel with the diamond turn face you would have seen on James Bond's DB10 in the film Spectre. Moving around to the rear of the car, we can see you've got this black finishing here, and then it's layered, and basically this car has got black contrasting roof strakes. Now, the black roof strakes give a really contemporary appearance, but you can go for a slightly more elegant look where these laser etched and cut out roof strakes are finished in a brushed aluminium look. Also, you can have them in the body colour. Also, the roof panel itself on this particular car is painted in gloss black. So the whole effect is that of a floating roof panel. But this can also be had in the body colour. And again, with DB11, like with any Aston Martin, there's loads of scope for customisation. There are almost some basic mathematical principles when it comes to designing an Aston Martin, and not a lot of people know this. Now, I'm not basically saying that our designers work off maths, because there's so much more that goes into designing the most beautiful car in the world. But we do have to take into account that with any Aston Martin, within the bulk of the body of the car, essentially that takes up 2/3, while the glasshouse area takes up 1/3. Now, when we move to the back of the car, we kind of flip that on its head a little bit. So the bulk of the body, again, takes up 2/3, but instead of having a glasshouse to deal with, we have a rear diffuser section, and that takes up 1/3. Now, the rear diffuser is essentially the element that anchors the bum of the car and gives it some of that aggression and some of that muscular look. And in this case, it's finished in gloss black, so it works really well with the contrasting body colour. And you'll remember the gloss black is also applied to the side sills and to the front splitter. Now, there's some really neat detailing around the tailpipes. And the tailpipes themselves, which can be available in either this bright finish or in a mottled black finish, are quite cool as well in the way that they are sheared and sawn off. Now, when we come to the lights, these are the thinnest LEDs that we could possibly productionise to create our trademark boomerang tail lamp design. And when you look within the actual lens, you have this Aston Martin wing effect. So essentially this apes and mirrors the Aston Martin trademark badger. Within the boot, great efforts have gone into engineering so that this doesn't have to have any kind of aero spoiler or ducktail, much like you see on the DB9 before it. A DB car should be incredibly elegant, incredibly graceful, and spoilers aren't typically seen as being a graceful styling design. So within that, we've engineered this aero blade. And when we go into the engineering of the car and how that links to dynamics, we'll talk a little bit more about it. It wouldn't be an Aston Martin if you couldn't create your own bespoke and special vehicle. Now, we're a little bit limited by having just one car in the showroom, but it's a prototype, so what we're going to do. So we need to show to our customers potentially a variety of different options. Now, this gave the Aston Martin designers sort of carte blanche to come up with their own ideal specifications, and we called these design choices. Now, I'm just going to talk you through some of the designer choices that are available and some highlights that show the various personalisation and customisation options that you can do on the DB11. So we'll start here with a vehicle called New Heritage. New Heritage is essentially an old school Aston Martin for the modern era, and it is in a new interpretation of Aston Martin Racing Green called Arden Green. And then we have this traditional copper tan and bitter chocolate duotone leather interior with the broguing. The side straights are in the contrasting brushed silver finish. And all in all, it creates a very elegant, very British, and you can imagine this being really popular in the USA because it's probably their interpretation as well of what a British sports car should be. Now, something very different to that is Intrepid Sport. This is probably one of the most assertive and aggressive looking DB11s in terms of what we could design. So we have the exterior colour of Cinnabar Orange, which is a really burnt, earthy, fantastic looking colour, and then contrasting black camp rails, which give a really assertive look. These are the diamond turned wheels with a black back, which again is just really powerful. And then we have black grills, black side scrapes, and black veins here, and all in all, it's just a really racy look. The interior is very nice as well. They've gone for something quite plain, but you have the broguing in the centre with contrasting stitching on either side. And in this particular spec, they've gone for my favourite of all the interior veneers, which is the crushed carbon. Then we move to something called Soft Tech. Now, Soft Tech I really, really like. It's very soft, essentially. It's very neutral in terms of the tones that it uses. It's very, very elegant. So the exterior colour is lightning silver, which was the launch colour on DBS, and it's sort of quite famous in amongst Aston Martin aficionados for that reason, but also because it has a load of depth. It changes from a very bright silver to a sort of silvery blue. It's got a real pearl-like quality to it. And then that paired with the very neutral contrasting side rails, because they don't contrast at all, essentially. And then we have this ice mocha and ivory duotone leather interior, which just very naturally flows from the exterior colours, and a very earthy dark ash wood. And I really love this because if you can imagine it in huge swathes on the doors, it's just got a really organic and sort of tactile effect. It's just really beautiful, that particular spec. So coming along here, come to a real statement piece specification. This is called Shanghai Fashionista. And Shanghai Fashionista has got a really Hollywood colour going for it, which is essentially this frosted glass blue paint. Now, Q are the bespoke department within Aston Martin. It stands for quality. However, it does bear connotations to the quartermaster in James Bond. But Q have come up with a certain number of configurable options that you can just tick off the spec sheet. And one of them is this blue paint. The reason it's so special is because typically in a metallic paint, you would have bits of metal, and that's what creates the fleck. In this instance, it's got bits of glass. And once it's out in the sun, it just has this sparkle that you can't replicate in a normal metallic paint finish. So truly, truly special with that. Because that's such a bright color, it works really well with a contrasting black roof strake. And with the wheels diamond turned with a black back and all the other black elements, it's a really dynamic looking car. Inside, I've gone for something really special. So you have this blue leather with ivory, and the bit that's kind of quite edgy and quite racing, this has come from Marek Reichman, who is the design director of Aston Martin, is you've got this spicy red leather behind the broguing and spicy red stitching. Again, they've gone for brushed carbon in there. So that, I think that's a really stunning car. And actually, we've had a few people express interest in ordering that particular specification. Then we move on to one with the sort of enigmatic name of Mysterious Sport. Mysterious Sport's a really nice one. We haven't really looked at DB11 in black, but it's got a real panther look to it. It's very svelte, it's very stealth. And this one's been paired with the shadow chrome wheels we've physically seen on the car in front of us today, and loads of other black elements, so it really is quite stealthy. The ultramarine black that they've chosen is an AML special paint, and what's special about it is it's got a blue within it, so it's kind of ink-like, and it's really luxuriant when you see it. And when the light hits it, it kind of pulls out this blue sparkle, which is just really, really special. Then you've got black on the cap rails, the roof scrapes, and inside opted for a leather called Dark Knight, which essentially is a black leather with a hint of blue, so something that really mirrors the exterior colour of the car. The stitching is indigo, so there's a slight purple to it, which again gives it a lot of luxury and a slight edge. And then inside, very simple, with huge swathes of piano black lacquer on the interior fascia and the door trims. And the final one, again, which has come from Marek Reichman, is Iconic Craft. And I think amongst all of them, this is the one that sort of seemed to be the complete summation of what a modern Aston Martin should be. So the sort of typical color for a modern Aston is typically black, grey or silver. We've developed a new one, which is called Magnetic Silver, and there's loads of fleck in it. And the car that we've been walking with today is in that exterior colour. It's a real feature of having the brushed metal roof strings. And then inside, quite traditional, but we have this Sahara tan leather interior. And essentially, this was the same as the vehicle that we sat in when we were at the Geneva Motor Show. And it has a Q option wood called satin tan lacework, which has a real, sort of tactility to it and a real depth and texture when you see it paired to all these other rich materials.